There are four intramolecular pathways proposed for racemization in tris-coordinate complexes. And let's take a look at push-through mechanism. And here we have two models of the same enantiomer. And here you can see this is the same enantiomer. This and these are equivalent, and this chelate and this chelate are equivalent, and this chelate are equivalent. Basically, here we have two models of the same enantiomer. I'll keep this one for reference, and I'll use this one for demonstrating the push-through mechanism. In push-through mechanism, all ligating atoms come into one plane like this. I mean, before going to demonstrate, just please take a note at the color of these bonds. I purposefully used these three colors here and the other, three bonds in one color, the other three bonds in another color. Now, all the ligating atoms come into one plane. Like this. These are not that great models. Okay. Once they come into one plane, then these three bonds can come up and those three can go down and give you the same enantiomer, or they can go further down and these can come further up. The yellow ones can come up further to give the mirror image of this one. And there are 50-50 chances once you have this transition state. Let me see how. Now we have yellow color bonds coming up, the green color ones going down. Now you have an octahedral complex again, the tris-chelate octahedral complex. And now let us see whether this is a mirror image of this one. Now take a look at it. And this is a perfect mirror image of the other enantiomer. And this one, and this, and this. This is a mirror image. In push-through mechanism, the transition state is sterically heavily crowded. Let's take a look at it. Because six ligating atoms are there in one plane around the metal. So this is not a preferable mechanism, because this requires a tremendous amount of energy because it is sterically crowded, so therefore bonds needs to be stretched out. So that means a tremendous amount of energy is required. So therefore this push-through mechanism is not a preferred mechanism. Another intramolecular pathway is crossover. In this crossover mechanism, four atoms come into one plane, and I'm going to demonstrate now. Now, again, we have two models of the same enantiomer. You can see that here, and these are equivalent. And I keep this one for reference, and I use this one for demonstration. In crossover, one chelating ligand does not change its position. So I just keep this one, the blue colored ones, in the same position, and the two atoms from these two chelate rings come into one plane like this. You can see that these two atoms came and then formed the plane with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 atoms total. That's one plane. And here you have another plane, 1, 2, 3. This plane is perpendicular to the other plane. So this is the transition state in crossover mechanism. Take a look at this. And once you have the transition state, either these two atoms can go back to its original position and give this isomer, the same isomer, original isomer, or this can come further forward and this can go further backward to give the mirror image of this isomer, enantiomer. Let's take a look at this. And take a look at this. Now we have an octahedron here, again tris-chelate complex. And let's take a look at this, whether there are mirror images or not. You can see that these are mirror images. And compare these, this is a mirror image, and these two are mirror images, and these two are mirror images. And again, similar to the push-through mechanism, here also there are basically four atoms occupying one plane and half of this plane basically. So therefore these are sterically heavily crowded. So therefore this also requires stretching of bonds, which is highly energy demanding. So therefore, this pathway is also not operative in tris-chelate complexes.